Sheetgo enables you to automate your work by creating workflows based on your spreadsheets. With Sheetgo, you can save time and eliminate tedious data manipulation by simply connecting your spreadsheets and transferring data between them in a workflow. The best part is you can do this all without needing the help from your IT department. And so Sheetgo is available as a web app at app.sheetgo.com, but what we're debuting in this video is our new Excel add-in. And to do so, we set up a pretty common use case that we see from a lot of finance departments. We know you finance guys out there, you really love your ERPs to track your actual expenses, but you always do your budgeting and forecasting in your spreadsheets. And so in this example, you can imagine I'm a finance manager, I'm doing my budget for my company, and I need the inputs from the various departments in my company in order to create this forecast. And you can see on the dashboard that we set up here, I have four departments. This orange bar represents what I've allocated to them, and you can see that the planned I haven't received yet, they're planning, which is why I can't complete my pro forma income statement here. And so what am I going to do? I'm going to use our consolidate feature to bring in data from those four source spreadsheets and put it in this spreadsheet, actually in this tab Sheetgo Budget, which you can see is blank now. I'm going to bring the data from the sources, the four sources, put it here, and it'll automatically populate my dashboard based on, you know, the graphs that I've already set up. And so in order to do so, with the Sheetgo sidebar open, I say start connecting. Here I can say if I want to bring in from one file or multiple files. In this case, I'm bringing from multiple files on my SharePoint. And it's a good point to mention, we can bring data from spreadsheets stored on SharePoint, on OneDrive, on Dropbox, and on Google Drive. So I'm gonna select the SharePoint site where I set this up, intro to Sheetgo, and then I'm gonna find the folder where these four spreadsheets resides. This is the department budgets, and then I'm gonna select the four spreadsheets individual, one for each of my departments, and select done. And so at this point, I should also notice it could be an Excel file, a TSV, a Google Sheet, or even a CSV file. And so what it's done is it's found those four files, it's loaded the tabs. I'm gonna bring in data from the monthly budget tab of each of these four files. I'm gonna select done here. And then on my destination, which is the sheet that I'm working in now, the only thing I'm gonna change here is I'm gonna change the name of the tab to the one I've already set up, monthly budget. So if I hadn't changed the name there, it would create actually a new tab in this sheet, but in order for the dashboard and formulas to work, we preset this tab for you guys. So select done editing, finish and save. And at this point, it's creating the connection, and it's gonna take a few seconds to bring the data in. Okay, as you can see, the data is here. Now the graphs have refreshed, and all I gotta do is click to save this workflow. And if I wanted to at this point, I can schedule my updates to run automatically, but I'm just gonna click finish for now. And you can see it, I have my workflow here in my add-in, which I can also access via our web app. And so just to sum up, that was an example of where we had distributed databases. In this case, it's budgets, and we brought it to a single place in this file. You can imagine there's similar use cases with sales, when you want to bring sales leads to a single place, maybe in project management when you have various entities with different inputs, or even like in OKRs, an HRU use case where you're tracking data. And then we also do the opposite. Instead of consolidating data, we can distribute data as well. So you can imagine use cases, again, project management. Well, I want to distribute tasks from a central database to multiple spreadsheets so all of my colleagues have access to their tasks. That's a great example of how we do the opposite, which is distribute data. And you know, the most simple is we can just go one-to-one. Anywhere we want to share data between A and B, essentially creating a mirror in the destination of what's in the source, that's where you do a simple one-to-one connection. So that's it for now. You can find our add-in in the Microsoft store where you find all your add-ins. Thanks a lot.